My name is Felipe Meza. I am a professor of economics at ITAM, which is a private university in Mexico City. And well, I have kept a close connection with US economics departments. I thank the Becker Friedman Institute for this opportunity to talk about Mexico, and I'm very happy to be here today. The four forces would be the switch from a primary deficit to a sequence of primary surpluses. This is one force. And this is a very basic mechanism that should be taught in every school, economics school in the world. This is one force that reduced inflation in Mexico. Another force, so back in the late 1980s, beginning of the 1990s, two different governments in Mexico decided to create a mechanism called the pactos, or agreements. So the government promised, committed to reduce spending. Union leaders committed to not to ask for very high wage increases, and businessmen committed to reduce increases in prices and to increase productivity. The main goal was to try to break the inflation inertia that had settled in Mexico at the beginning of the 1980s. So this is a second force. A third force, and I think this is very important, is a constitutional reform in Mexico in 1993. So in 1993, the constitution was changed, and there were two crucial changes regarding the central bank. So the central bank, for the first time in history, was giving a goal, and the goal was to have low inflation. And a second change in the constitution was to make the central bank independent from the treasury, from the fiscal branch of the government. So this is what I tell my students. Mexico has had many reforms, and we don't see the positive impact of too many of these, but I think this one is very important, and I think it was effective. The last force, the fourth one, would be the implementation of an inflation targeting regime in Mexico. So this regime is very simple. The central bank announces what it wants inflation to be. The official target today is 3%, and it is very easy to evaluate whether the central bank is doing a good job or not. I mean, economists can complain to the central bank that inflation is off target. This is very simple, and then the central bank would have to react. And so this regime was announced in 2000, implemented in 2002, and inflation fell very quickly to this 3% level. Well, this is the biggest question for Mexico. If we divide Mexico into states or sectors linked to the US economy, then that part of Mexico grows very fast. So if we talk about the north or central Mexico, so this part of the country is export-oriented, and it grows very fast. If we look at the south is poorer, less educated. This part of Mexico doesn't grow. So what can be done to make Mexico grow faster? Well, I guess exposure to trade would be very important. And then there are other forces, for example, public education. And there has been a reform in public education with the goal of increasing quality. This should bring benefits to the overall population, which is what matters, right? So I would just focus for now on these two forces. How do we make the southern part of Mexico grow? How do we expose it to trade in a successful way? And how do we make sure that the quality of education increases in Mexico? So if we change these two things, Mexico may grow faster.